It's that time of year, folks. Our list of the best note-taking applications 2023. I'm excited to dive into this and help you pick your next note-taking application. So welcome to Keep Productive. My name is Francesco D'Alessio, and welcome. If you're new here, do subscribe. If you are already an amazing subscriber of ours, please do check out the newsletters. We've got some new ones that you'll find in the link in the description. And most importantly, if you are somebody that wants an in-depth review of all of the tools that we mentioned, we've got a brand new service called Toolfinder. You can find it in the link in the description and get in-depth reviews about all of the apps we're mentioning today. So these aren't in a particular order. There's no ranking to this, but let's dive into all of these apps. So the first one is Evernote. And Evernote has been around the market for absolutely ages. 2004, I think it was first initiated as an application, and it's just actually been acquired, well, in the process of acquisition as we speak, by an app maker called Bending Spoons. We got a full video on that if you want to dive in, but Evernote is a great all-round note-taking application. It's got some great capture abilities. It's got some really in-depth abilities when it comes to building out your notes, but also your tasks and calendar more recently. With the professional and premium plan features that they do have, it is a pretty nice experience if you're looking to make sort of like a hub for your productivity and be able to embed some tasks inside of your notes and calendar items. But Evernote still remains probably one of the most all-round productivity applications for notes in particular. So next up is Amplenote. And we've done a few features on Amplenote, and it's really grown since last time we talked about it. Much like Evernote, it's including a lot of tasks and lots of calendar abilities. We'll mention those in a moment, but primarily Amplenote is a great blend between a traditional note-taking application and what people are calling PKM tools. Probably wondering, what's a PKM tool? It means personal knowledge management. But these PKM tools help you to connect one note to another note and build a sort of relationship between them. But Amplenote sort of does that, but in more of a traditional note-taking fashion. Now, Amplenote also adds something called tasks. We all know tasks, but it takes it a step further with something called task score, which essentially helps you to rank your tasks based on importance and a few other attributes to give it a ranking, which is quite a cool little system to making sure that you understand what is important on your list and what is not. It's also got some calendar abilities, and it's really grown out some of the core functions, including tables, etc., inside of each of the notes that you take. So an interesting development over the last year from Amplenote. So number three is Obsidian. Now Obsidian, again, another really popular one, but much more popular with those who are PKM users. That personal knowledge management has gotten really popular, and allowing you to connect one note to another is just a starting point. In Obsidian, you can map out your data or the notes that you created in what we call a graph. And a lot of people like Obsidian because it's locally stored, unless you upgrade to the sync and publish ability in your vaults, which are stored on your Mac device, which is pretty cool because a lot of people like the fact that they have their notes locally stored and it's all on their device versus being out in the cloud. And Obsidian has grown a big community in the last couple of years, especially in the Markdown space, helping people to create great relationships between their notes and go further with their plugins and themes ability. If you do want to learn Obsidian, we've got a fantastic course on it, which is probably one of the most popular courses in Obsidian right now. You can check that out in the link in the description. So number four, we have Logseq. Now, again, very much like Obsidian and Roam, Logseq has grown in popularity with its community being the bustling place that it is online. But Logseq is a great open source experience for taking notes, and it really does have some great themes and abilities for connecting up notes. And very much like Obsidian, it runs a similar ship as that. Now, if you want a full beginner's guide, a 30-minute tour of Obsidian, Logseq, we've actually done that with Dario Da Silva, if you want to check out here in the channel. So number five, moving away from the more in-depth note-taking applications, there's one that is a Markdown note-taking application called Bare Notes. But Bare Notes is a little bit more relaxed. It's got an iOS and a Mac application, and it's very much a well-designed experience, winning plenty of awards in the past. But Bare Notes focuses on organizing your notes based on a hashtag, which is quite cool. And it's definitely much more for a simple note taker over something that may be potentially more advanced like Obsidian and Logseq. It's great for creating recipes, bringing your ideas together, clipping stuff on the go, but it's very simplified in its layout and experience. And what it is, it's nice sort of blend between Apple Notes and Evernote, but in a more simplistic fashion. Number six is Notion. Now, we know Notion as this all-in-one experience, and you can go a lot further with Notion, but a lot of people have found a great hub for its notes and its more flexible nature with databases, allowing you to create whatever properties and sort of structure that you want for a note-taking application. So it's gained a lot of notoriety with people clipping stuff on the web, but also people who like the Readwise integration as well for taking book summaries and notes as they're on their Kindle or they're being able to clip stuff on web. And they've also got a great web clipper Notion do for being able to bring stuff into a note-taking application. And more recently, they've launched database templates to help you to create recurring database templates, which is perfect for journaling and creating routine notes. So Notion has a great note-taking base and obviously has that layer up on many of these other applications in allowing you to do much more in terms of manage your projects, manage your tasks, and be that all-in-one hub for your work. Number seven is Standard Notes. Now, you may not have heard of this one, but it's very much a privacy-focused note-taking application. Now, to be honest, it's sort of like a blend between the likes of Bear Notes and Evernote, a sort of mid-ground between them, but provides you with a very clean interface that is stored very much securely. They use more focused security. I will post some of their security and privacy manifestos in the link in the description, but it's very much, much more in depth than you would expect in apps like Evernote and Amplenote and things like that. Now, Standard Notes has a pretty steep pricing as in terms of like a 5-year pricing and things like that, but it does have some great themes and in-depth plugins if you're looking to go further and sign up to their pricing plans. So number eight is Google Keep. Now, you may know Google Keep. It's a very simple note-taking experience. I actually call it the post-it notes for the web, allowing you to create little post-it notes that you can create on your mobile device and even on your Apple Watches these days. And it's a great little way to be able to create small, short reminders, reminder-based stuff as well, so tagging a note with a reminder, and also be able to take pictures and upload them, and using AI, using Google's search engine, you can actually find them with just a search term. So Google Keep has gotten really popular with those who want a simple note taker and a reliable one that is run by a service like Google. Number nine is Mem. Now, before we begin this one, we're actually an investor in Mem, but you can read the full statement and how that affects our reviews here on Keep Productive below. So Mem is a more AI-focused note-taking application, but to be honest, it doesn't really know what it is yet. It is a way to create notes, and using their auto-tagging and folders, it sort of removes the aspect of organization from your system. Now, it does have some team sharing abilities, which make it great for collaborating with team members. However, as a note taker, it's very simple. It does have some functions like Flow to help you set up templates, to help you create these templates from your notes, a bit like Daily Notes and Craft, which we'll talk about in a moment. But Mem is an interesting application because it embeds AI, allowing you to do some generative AI functions. To be honest, it's quite a medium ground note taker right now, but not necessarily the note taker out of all of these that I'd recommend because it's slowly evolving to what it needs to be. It doesn't have an iOS application yet. So do check it out below, but as I said, not necessarily something that is suitable for everyone. So moving on to number 10, and number 10 is Clover. You may not have heard of Clover, but it is a notes project application. It's a very strange one. It acts very much like Notion and Walling, Again, another sort of pseudo project note-taking application, but Clover allows you to organize all of your notes and also use your Apple Pencil and some of the sketching abilities to go and blend your notes with your drawings as well. But it also has some of the functions like daily notes and linking that people do like in a note-taking application in the PKM space. But Clover, again, is a much more advanced structure than, say, you would get inside of Evernote or Obsidian. It's much more of a collaborative note taker than those. A little bit like Mem to some extent in the way that it's positioning itself. Number 11, Zoho Notebook. Now, Zoho Notebook is actually a more advanced Google Keep. It presents a really nice experience, some great audio capture functionality, some great post-it note-like capture functionality. And as I said, it's just more enhanced Google Keep. It really does have a great clipper and some great applications that come along with it. So if you're looking for something that's a blend between or in the middle ground between Google Keep and Evernote, this is actually a good option. Moving on to number 12, which is Craft. Now Craft, I would say, is a personal documents application, but a lot of people are using it as a note-taking experience. And Craft presents a really clean interface. It works beautifully on iOS and Mac, and they're releasing it on web and Windows too. And it's been growing in popularity due to the build quality and experience that it offers. Now you can create pages inside of this and very much create a structure like you would inside of Notion, but it does have great abilities with daily notes in particular and linking stuff up too. A lot of people like how you can create a craft document, share it, and also keep it as your daily journal too, and have team functions on the side as well. So Craft presents a great personal docs slash note-taking experience and one that's very well built. Number 13, Agenda Notes. Now, you might have heard of Agenda Notes. It's won many Apple Awards in the past for its beautiful design and quality. Now, Agenda Notes presents itself as a notes and a calendar application because what it does, like the name, is try to present a way for you to associate your notes to a calendar event. It's calendar slash notes driven note-taking application, if that makes sense. Now, this is perfect for scheduling, like for example, associating notes to dates in the future. Like for example, if you've got something on your calendar, like a meeting coming up, or you maybe you got a holiday coming up and you're creating a pack list. If you're somebody that finds yourself associating dates with notes, this might be the application for you, and it's really well designed. And it does host a lot of stuff in the premium that you might like, particularly templates and things like that. Now, number 14 is Supernotes. Supernotes is a really well-designed application, but it's much more targeted towards students because it's focused on more flashcard-based notes, connecting them up and also being able to share them with other people and collaborate. But whilst it's gained a lot of popularity in the student space, it's also gained a lot of popularity with those who are using it as a note-taking application, but one that doesn't necessarily go as deep as, say, Obsidian and Logseq, and has a really friendly interface like Evernote. So it's sort of a middle ground between those ones. But Supernotes, growing in popularity, and it does look really beautiful. Number 15, we have Remnote. This is much more focused towards students. It's flashcard-based and presents itself as a more serious, student-focused version of Supernotes, going that step further and really helping you to really use that active recall in helping you to remember study cards and collaborating with others. Now, some people do use it as an Obsidian, Logseq, and Roam alternative, but it does present itself as more of a flashcard note-taking application that can help you to organize research and ideas and student-based work in one application. And finally, we have probably missed a few, I'll mention that in a moment, but Zenkit Hypernotes. This is a really simple way to create notes, but also link them to other notes. It is built by the folks at Zenkit. They got a suite of applications already, like Zenkit To Do, which is a popular to-do list application, but Hypernotes is a nice blend between the likes of Evernote and, again, a bigger PKM tool like Obsidian. It won't give you the in-depth and abilities as we'd expect in Amplenote or Logseq, but it does give you a fair few features for being able to take notes and collaborate with others. So Hypernotes, a good alternative as a good minimal but easy to use PKM tool, a much more front sort of easy getting started versus the more intense Obsidian and Logseq, which a lot of people know already. So we may have missed a fair few note-taking applications here, but it's your opportunity to share your application that you use and why you use it. It's great to have this opinion in the comments below because people could share their own experience and how they get on with it. But remember, do not share the link because it won't come through on the spam on YouTube comments, but we would love to see it. So make sure you don't share that link there. Anyway, folks, a huge, huge thank you here. Please do check out the full list on Toolfinder, which will be linked in the description below, as well as our other subscription newsletters. And if you're interested, do follow us here on Keep Productive for more in-depth reviews and the latest productivity apps and features. Thank you very much, folks, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Cheers, everyone. Bye. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you're interested in checking out some more, you'll find them here. And also you can subscribe too as well. It'd be great to have you here to optimize your tool. And if you're interested in our new email newsletters or our Bento application, or even Toolfinder, which is a new tool that we've created to help you find the perfect productivity tool, you can find it linked in the description.